Now we have next is numeric data types, numbers, P and S. This is precision is the total length. Remember, I think while we were going through some topic, I was talking about this. P is the total length of your number and S is the digits after the decimal. This one data type, you have a lot of questions in your certification and it will confuse you a lot. I'm going to show you some examples right now and then let us see if you guys are able to follow me or not. So I have a column which is defined as number. The size is 5.2. Okay, now I'll try to insert some values inside this column. You guys tell me whether the value will be inserted inside the column or not. So the first value I'm trying to insert is 100.12. Can we insert this value inside the table or not? In this case, guys, the total length of your number or the value that you are inputting should not exceed 5. Okay, so we count the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so the length, the complete length of your number is 5, and out of which 2 digits are allowed after decimal. So we see that 2 digits are after decimal. That means this will go inside the column. Now what if I have this value? So this value will not go inside this column. It will throw an error because we have 3 digits onto the right side of the decimal. Now take a guess on this one, 1.1. Do you think this value will be inserted into the table or the column or not? Yes guys, this value will also be inserted into the table because these are maximums or the max numbers or the max digits. That doesn't mean any value below them will not be inserted. All right, so 5 is the maximum number of characters in the number that you're trying to insert. So that means in this case we only have 2 characters, right? So still it will be inserted, and it says that maximum of 2 characters can be after the decimal. So if we still have one number or one digit after the decimal, it's still okay, it will be accepted. Someone asked me earlier, what's the difference between number and integer? Guys, this integer data type, this is actually IBM defined data type. All right, so what Oracle did is, because Oracle wants to be different, Oracle created their own numeric data type, that is number. So if you're working with other data types, you might see that the numeric data type is integer, but Oracle also have both the data types, but it forces you to use number more than integer, because what integer does is it's same as number with no scale. That means you cannot specify the point values or the decimal values. It will always round the given number. If you specify any value, it will round the number based on 1 to 5. So if the value is from 0 to 4, it will fall onto the previous value. If the value is from 5 to 9, it will move to the next value. Let us look at an example. So if it is 129.5, so what happens is this will be converted into 130 because this value falls under, let me help you, if it is 0 to 4, then it will round it to previous value, and if it is 5 to 9, then next value. If you see, this 5 falls under this next value category. In this case, 1 to 9, this 9 will be rolled up to one more value. That means it will be moved one digit up. So in this case, 1 to 9, you add 1 and it becomes 130. If you have a value 112.3, this will remain 112 because it falls under previous value. Previous means it remains the same. So I would rather write it add one. All right. So use integer only when you always want to round the numbers by default inside the database. Even if you specify a decimal, still it will be rounded. Otherwise, if you want to specify exact numbers in decimals, then go for the number data type. One more thing, guys, for salaries, always go with integer data type because it's good to have salary in the fixed numbers. We don't want decimal salaries, right? So if you have a salary column, it's good if you can define it as integer. But in this case, the S part and the P part, these both are optional. Even if you don't specify, Oracle will take the maximum length that is possible. Okay, so even if you don't specify P and S, it's still okay in the number column. Okay, let me try one. Let me create a test table for you. So create table test underscore one. And in this case, I am defining column one as number. I'm not giving the size. Okay, I'm not giving the column size. And if I hit enter, now can you see still the table is created? But I won't recommend to run queries like this. For test purpose, it's okay, but always use precision and scale for your numbers, right?